Good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. This is a good morning, and it's a beautiful day in our life because this is the day that the Lord has made.
Yes.
And we will rejoice and be glad in it because God is good all the time, and all the time God is good. And this is a good day to have a good day. Amen. When we are in Christ Jesus, every day is a good day. And we are looking forward to all of that the Lord is going to continue to do today, because he's already been good to us when he watched over us all night, woke us up this morning and clothed in our right mind with the mind to serve him.
Yes, that is
truly a blessing. God bless you. We love everyone. Thank you for your beautiful support.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, honoring the Bishop Lorenzo Coleman Sr. It's great joy that we are here. Our hearts are overjoyed to be in the service of the Lord, because he has been a faithful servant. He's been a faithful servant, and we serve him. Hallelujah. We honor him. He's our Savior. Praise God. We'd just like to honor Miracle House of Prayer and the Facebook audience. We thank God for you. We would love for you to write us at P.O. Box 681973 or call. We'll be glad to hear from you. 1-800-870-3414 with your prayer requests. We would be just glad to entreat the Lord in behalf of you and your situation. We realize that he's a healer, and he want to heal his people. He want us to walk in health. He want us to serve him, and we bless the Lord for that. We greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Without him, we can do nothing. I testify on this morning, hallelujah, that he's great. And he's here today to meet your needs.
Yes.
I feel no ways tired. I feel church.
Yes.
I feel like going on.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Though trials come on every hand, but I feel like going on. And the Lord say, oh, he'll carry us through. If you see footprints in the sand, hallelujah, he was carrying you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I feel no ways tired. Hallelujah. Our opening scripture this morning is Psalms 150, verses 1 through 6. A call to praise God. Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness.
Yes.
Praise him with the sound of the trumpet.
Hallelujah.
Praise him with the psaltery and harp.
Yes.
Praise him with the timbrel and dance. Praise him with string instruments and organs.
Yes.
Praise him upon the loud cymbals.
Yes.
Praise him upon the high sounding cymbals.
Man.
Let everything that hath breath, praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 We're going to go into prayer on this morning. Heavenly Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you that we have our health and strength to praise you, to lift your holy name, O God. You said, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. And we thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you, O God, that we're standing on solid rock, and that solid foundation is Jesus Christ. God, yes, we thank you. We ask that you would bless this people, oh God, that's under the sound of my voice. Ask that you would meet their needs, oh God. Father, we ask that we be attentive and receive the word of the Lord on today. These things we ask. In Jesus' name. Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Hallelujah. At this time, I'm going to give this service into the hands of our bishop. He's speaking to us today, and we thank God for such a man of God in an hour at this time. We need faithfulness. We need leadership. And we thank God for a faithful servant, the Bishop Lorenzo Coleman Sr. Amen.
God bless you, Pastor Lois Jean Coleman. God bless you so much. God bless everyone on today. Those that are watching us via Facebook as well as listening to us via the teleconference line, the Miracle House of Prayer teleconference line, we thank you for your faithfulness. We thank God for your beautiful support. We thank God for the new listeners that is coming on the Facebook page to listen to us each Sunday. We appreciate you. We don't take anything for granted. We are so grateful how the Lord is opening doors that no man can shut. Hallelujah. And most definitely, if the Lord shut a door, can no man open it. But we are glad that we have an open door today, that we can lift up holy hands and love him, praise him, give him glory for his mighty acts and all of the great things that he is doing, that he is doing continually, even in the midst of the pandemic. I can look around and I can see the handwork of God. We don't have to look very far to see that God is yet the God in this pandemic. We know that things are changing and we're able to do different things now. But one thing we want to continue to do is that we want to be prayerful and watchful. Amen. We want to continue to be safe as we serve our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I'm so grateful to be able to stand here today and share the unadulterated word of God. Amen. By revelation knowledge. Amen. The message that we shall share with you on today, on May the 2nd, May the 2nd, at 6 a.m., before I even got out of my bed, the Lord, the Holy Ghost, spoke this message to my spirit. Amen. So I'm glad that I lay down with a clear mind and a clear spirit in love with Jesus. So that means the Holy Ghost resided while I was sleeping, glory to God, within me. So when I awakened, this was the message that the Lord shared with me, and I'm so grateful to be able to share it with you today. Praise God. So we want you to notify somebody, call somebody up on the phone and tell them that Bishop Lorenzo Coleman Sr. has a message from God. Hallelujah. Amen. Yes, I worked on it. I prepared to present this message, but it was after the Holy Ghost had revealed what this message was to be today. And so we're going to go right ahead and we're going to jump into it, and we're going to try to jump as high as we can today in the spirit. Glory to God that you might enjoy what the Lord is saying. I want to say we are certainly thankful. We know that Mother's Day was last Sunday, and probably some might have not been able to watch us on last Sunday. There might be some mothers out there that we didn't get a chance to say Happy Mother's Day to you last Sunday. Well, a belated Happy Mother's Day to you. And remember, I said last Sunday that for my wife, every day is Mother's Day. Amen. That's because, amen, I strive to make it be that. Amen. And certainly you can too. Praise God. If I may, I want to share with you, and if you would, it's all right if you take some notes. Praise God. Because I'm like this. What God gives me is for the body of Christ. Amen. And we're not going to say anything about you taking notes from what the Lord gives me, because why? This is for the body of Christ, that the people of God may become better. Glory to God. So it's all right if you take some notes today. Amen. I want to talk with you the message that the Lord gave me on May the 5th at 6 a.m. The title being Moving in the Volume of His Understanding. Let me say that again. Moving in the volume of His understanding. And just one for the Father, one for the Son, and I'm going to say it a third time, one for the Holy Ghost. Moving in the volume of His understanding. Glory to God. Now, I know most of you already have gleaned the body of the message from the title of the message. But nevertheless, since the Lord gave it to me, I want to share with you that the Lord revealed to me. Glory to God. Moving in the volume of His understanding. Now, moving, we are very familiar with that word. Moving means, amen, that we want to go in a forward direction.
Yes.
Moving. And in means that whatever we are moving, we want to move in that direction. Keep in mind that word in, that little two-letter word in.
Yes.
Moving in the volume, and the volume, we want to say the measure. Volume is moving in a certain measure.
Yes.
Of His understanding. Of whose understanding? None other but the Lord Jesus Christ. Glory to God. Can you imagine if the body of Christ, if the called out born again believers, the body of Christ, the saints of God, of all denomination, can you imagine if we all would move in the volume of Jesus' understanding? Glory to God. I said, well, Bishop, is that possible?
Yes.
Well, through the word of God, it is possible. Why? Because when we are in Christ, we're going to move in Him. For Him, in Him, we're going to move.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. And we are, His understanding is where we are striving to get. Moving in the volume of His understanding. In other words, don't try to figure out with the carnal mind, amen, what the spirit man is doing, because it will never work. Glory to God. Move it in the volume of His understanding. Glory to God. Oh, this is getting good to me already. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm going to try not to leap over this pulpit here, this podium today. Amen. But I want to present this message, amen, that the body of Christ, amen, may grow higher, that the body of Christ might understand that we are not leaning to our own understanding. Glory to God. We could never please God if we're going to lean to our own understanding. Why? That's because if we are, then we are moving in the flesh. Amen. And there is no flesh that can please our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Moving in the volume of the measure of his understanding. Glory to God. I remember some years ago, there was a little hashtag that came out which said, hashtag WWJD. And I have never forgotten what that meant. And now you very seldom hear it anymore, but it meant, what would Jesus do? WWJD. Now, I didn't pen that, but I, learned about it through the news media and church. I learned about WWJD. Amen. Well, think about it. Amen. What would Jesus do? Now, what is his understanding about every situation and about every circumstance that we, the called out, born again body of believers, every situation that we would come up against, every decision that we would have to make, everything that someone would come to us, instead of us telling them, well, I believe, can we pray and say, well, the Lord said, glory to God, amen. That's because, amen, we can hear the voice of the Lord. Hallelujah. Moving in the volume of his understanding. Glory to God. And if I may go to the book of St. John, the 14th chapter, and one verse of scripture, the 12th verse. And Jesus said here, verily, verily, in other words, listen, listen. Jesus here is getting the attention of Philip. Jesus is having a conversation with Philip. And Jesus said, verily, 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 in other words, listen, listen. Glory. I say unto you, talking to Philip, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. Talking about who? Talking about his disciples. Glory to God. Not just Philip, but all of the disciples that was in Philip's time, all of the disciples that are in our time. This is Jesus talking, and he's not just talking to just one individual. He's conversing with one individual, which is Philip, but he's talking about all of his disciples everywhere. He's no respecter person, because that we do as people of God should be through the Spirit of God or through the Holy Ghost. Amen. And we can do all things through Christ, which strengthened us. Oh, moving in the volume of his understanding. And Jesus went on to tell Philip, he says, the works that I do, shall he do also, and listen at this, and greater, my God, works than these shall he do? Why? Because I go unto my Father. Now, you know, saints of God, people of God everywhere, if we would listen to the word of God, we will take the can't help us out of our life. We will take the can't help us out of the church. We will take the can't help us out of our home. Why? Because Jesus has a confidence in his disciples that these things that I do, ye shall do also. Why? Because I go unto my Father. Glory to God. He's not coming back to do the works that he's already done. No. He has given us power and strength and the anointing to move in his word and obey what thus said the word. So when we are moving, let's make sure that we are moving in the volume of his understanding. Let's make sure, in other words, we are doing the things that Jesus would do. Yes. Glory to God.
Glory.
Oh, hallelujah.
Glory.
Moving in the volume of his understanding. Moving in the measure of his understanding. Hallelujah. Oh, my God. I'm already excited. Hallelujah. If we would look in the book of Acts, the 17th chapter, in the 28th verse, and the A part, amen, of this verse here, says, for in him we live and move and have our being. In who? In Jesus Christ. We live, we move, and we have our being. Hallelujah. In Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. That's where, amen, we live and we move and we have our being. Glory to God. So moving in the volume of his understanding, glory to God, amen, we have to look beyond the carnal things. We have to look beyond carnality. We have to look beyond, glory to God, amen, the things, glory to God, that we, amen, might feel like we are incapable of doing, glory to God. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, but we are looking to go higher, saints of God. We are looking to become stronger, glory to God. Amen, because we are in a battle in this hour. Glory to God, amen. And there are things, glory to God, amen, that the enemy, glory to God, desire to do. But we are glad, amen, that we are looking to the hills from which our help, for our help coming from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. Glory to God. And he's not going to suffer our feet to be moved. Amen. Why? Because we, amen, are in Christ Jesus. Keep in mind that word in. We are in Christ Jesus, and we're going to stay in Christ Jesus, so that, amen, we might move in the volume of his understanding, that we will do what, amen, Jesus would do, amen, in all of these circumstances. Oh, glory to God. Now, we're moving on, amen, a little bit further here, amen, because this message is so embedded in my heart, my mind, my soul, and my body, amen, until, amen, we want you to enjoy what the Lord has shared also, amen. Now, we have to do some things to move in the volume of his understanding. We as human beings have to do something. Glory to God. And number one, we must crucify the flesh. Hallelujah. Make a note of that. Make a note of that. If we're going to move in the volume of his understanding, we're going to have to first, we're going to have to crucify the flesh. Amen. In other words, we're going to have to die daily. Glory to God. And I heard Paul saying in the book of Galatians, the 5th chapter and the 24th verse, Paul says, and that they are Christ have crucified the flesh with the affections and lusts. Glory to God. In other words, to move in the volume of his understanding, we must crucify the flesh. In other words, we must bring that flesh under subjection. Hallelujah. To the Spirit. Glory to God. To the Holy Ghost. Amen. It's not something that's impossible. It's not hard to do. We just have to have a made up mind. Glory to God. That we're going to do, amen, what we know that the word is telling us to do. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. And so in order to crucify the flesh, that we might move in the volume of his understanding, we are also going to realize, first of all, we really need to be saved. We need to be born again. Because if we're not saved, we're not born again, crucifying the flesh is going to be far from our memory, far from us, if we don't yield ourself to the Lord. Give our life to the Lord. Glory to God. And as Paul said in 2 Corinthians 5 and 17, Paul said to the church at Corinth, he said, therefore, if any man be in Christ, that is again, in Christ, in Christ. I like that. Hallelujah. Amen. See, we live in a society now, amen, that everybody don't want to be in Christ. Glory to God. Amen. Everybody wants what Christ has to offer. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Amen. The riches. Amen. Everybody would love to have the riches without Christ. Well, I say everybody, but a lot of people. Amen. Because we know beyond a shadow of a doubt that the word of God says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all of these things will be added unto you. Amen. In other words, if we serve the Lord, not only is it going to pay off after a while, but it's going to pay off right now. Glory to God. So, amen. In order to move in the volume of his understanding, let's position ourselves. Let's get ourselves in position. Glory to God. A position to do what? Obey the word of God. Hallelujah. Amen. It's not something that's hard to do. No, it's easy to do because, amen, the word can do it through us. Hallelujah. Oh, I love, amen, this word on today. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. In Christ, he is a new creature. In other words, he is a new creation. And Paul went on to say, old things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. Hallelujah. You see the difference? When, amen, all things become new. All things mean all things. The old things are passed away. Amen. Don't make no sense, amen, to try to put the old wine, amen, and try to put it, amen, into a new bowl. Glory to God. Don't make any sense. Hallelujah. Oh, but amen. Let's get rid of all of them old things. You know what? The Holy Ghost will let us know what's clean and what's unclean. Oh, yes, it will. Oh, yes, it will. And we need to, amen, go back, amen, and sing, amen, a little song, amen, Search me, Lord.
Yes.
Search me, Lord. And if you find anything that shouldn't be, take it out and strengthen me. Because I want to be right.
Glory.
I want to be saved. I want to be whole. Glory to God. Amen. That's, amen, a good thing, amen, to come before the Lord, amen, and lay out before him, amen, and amen, in his presence, glory to God, that, amen, because we want to be used of him. Hallelujah. Jesus said, amen, these things that I do, ye shall do, and greater, unless we get in Christ and stay in Christ, we will not accomplish these greater things, and we're not going to do nothing great without Christ. We got to get in him, remain in him,
yes,
be steadfast in him. Glory to God, because he wants to use us in this hour, just like he told Philip, glory to God, and the other disciples of that day, glory to God, amen. Jesus was having a conversation with Philip, and he talked to Philip, and he told Philip this, amen, 14 and 12 is what Jesus answered to Philip, his disciple. I'm glad I'm a disciple.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I'm glad I'm a disciple. Hallelujah. And I'm saying to the Lord, Lord, I want to present myself to you every day that I might be used of you. Glory to God. Every day, everywhere I go, I want to be used of you.
Yes.
Glory to God. If I may, go to the book of Philippians, the second chapter and the fifth verse. Here's what Paul said to the church at Philippi. Paul says, let this mind be in you,
yes,
which was also in Christ Jesus. There we go again with that little small two-letter word, I-N, in. See, it's a difference in being around Christ. It's a difference in knowing about Christ, but the best thing to do is to be in Christ. That's the best place to be, in Christ. That way, amen, we can move, amen, in the volume of his understanding. We can move in the measure of his understanding, amen, when we are in him. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. My God. My God. If I may, after we've crucified ourselves,
yes,
then the most important thing that we need to do is to walk in love. Everything that we do should be done because of love, not because of lust. Not because of what we can gain personally for ourselves. Glory to God. That will come when we walk in love.
Yes.
The love of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And in 1 Corinthians 13 and 13, it says, now abideth faith, hope, charity.
Yes.
These three.
Yes.
But the greatest of these is charity. Glory to God. See how important it is, amen, to be serious about what we're doing for Christ.
Yes.
For if we love him, we will keep his commandments. Glory to God. If we love him, we will do the things that he say do. Hallelujah. WWJD. Think about it. What would Jesus do?
Yes.
in that every situation. Well, love will take care of it. Glory to God. After we crucify the flesh, then we need something to walk in. And that's walk in the spirit and walk in love. Hallelujah. Making Jesus our first choice. Yes. And he will lead and he will guide and he will direct us. Love your enemies. Love your friends, which is no problem loving your friends. But I had a friend of mine that said that they're not able to love their enemies just yet. And I said, well, you know what? Don't give up on yourself. Keep working on yourself. Hallelujah. Amen. For unless we forgive our enemies, we haven't really did anything. Hallelujah. Your enemies is that one that hates you. Your enemies is that one that despitefully use you. That's the one that will laugh in your face and talk about you behind your back. See, that those are the type of things that the enemy does. But you know, you got to love them. Don't love what they're doing, but love that person. Glory to God. We have to have a clear life, a clear mind, and a clear life to move in his understanding. Glory to God. Moving in his understanding. For Galatians 5 and 25 says, if we live in the spirit, let us also walk in the spirit. See, we've crucified the flesh and we love. Now it's time to walk in the spirit. To walk in the Holy Ghost, in other words. Hallelujah. Walking in the Holy Ghost is a good place to be. If we live in the spirit, if our life is in the spirit, if our life is in the Holy Ghost, then let us also walk in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Or we'll get into where we need to go now. Amen. Because what? It's not I. Glory to God. But it's the Christ that lives within me. Hallelujah. That will give me the power, the strength, because of the anointing. Hallelujah. Amen. To move in the measure of his understanding. Glory to God. I understand, amen, that he's a healer. All right. Hallelujah. Yes, he is. Did he not heal, amen, many? Yes, he did. So let's move in his understanding. Not what the doctors say, you can't be healed from this. You can't be healed from that. You can't be healed from cancer. You can't be healed from diabetes. And amen, I like amen the way Apostle Jennings always told us, said, Christ died. When I came alive, when Christ died. Come on. So don't say we can't. Hallelujah. Because I can do all things through Christ, which strengthened us. Oh, yes, we can. Now, after, amen, loving, we're going to have to, amen, walk in obedience. Hallelujah. Walk in obedience. Amen. We could, amen, do some good things, but we're going to have to walk in obedience. Jesus did. Jesus walked in obedience unto the Father. Glory to God. An earthly soul, when he walked, amen, the earth, glory to God, he obeyed his parents. Oh, yes, he did. Hallelujah. You see, there's an order. Amen. But let's be obedient. Hallelujah. Saints of God, no matter who you are, there is somebody that you should be obedient to. If you're not in leadership, you need to get in leadership that you can be obedient unto your leader. Hallelujah. Jesus was obedient to God. Hallelujah. Oh, I'm loving this. In Philippians 2 and 8, Paul said to the church at Philippi, and being found in fashion as a man, talking about Jesus, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. My Lord, what an awesome example of obedience. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ became obedient to the Father, even unto death. My God, isn't that awesome to know, amen, that we, yes, we are in the flesh, we're walking in the flesh, but we're not living in the flesh, but we are to be obedient to leadership as word, as well as to the word of God. Hallelujah. That's why, amen, sometimes the people in the church don't grow like they're supposed to, because instead of wanting to be obedient, they want to run everything. Instead of being obedient to the bishop, they got a vision of themselves. Hallelujah. Amen. But if you got a vision, amen, that the Lord has given you, you ought to, amen, bring it to the bishop and to the pastor. Discuss that vision with leadership. Amen. Because if you try to go over and above leadership, you're not going to get nowhere anyhow. And I did say anyhow. Hallelujah. Moving in the volume of his understanding. We want to move in the right spirit. Glory to God. We want to move, amen, at the right time. Glory to God. Reading, amen, a little further here, St. John 10 and 4. And St. John 10 and 4 says, and when he put it forth his own sheep, he goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. We as people of God, we as disciples, must know his voice. Yes, he yet speaks. He speaks through the word of God. Also, he speaks audibly. But you have to have an ear to hear. He's speaking daily. But are you in a position to hear what he's saying? You want to move in the right direction at the right time? You want to move in his understanding? Then you must have an ear to hear what the voice of Jesus is saying unto us. Oh, hallelujah. Moving in the volume of his understanding. In that fifth verse, St. John 10 and 5, and Jesus said, and a stranger will they not follow. You see, we as people of God, when we know the voice of the Lord, we're not going to follow the voice of a stranger. Just like the sheep, glory to God, they knew the voice of their shepherd. And when the shepherd came for the sheep, naturally so, they knew his voice. And they would only follow their shepherd. Oh, isn't that beautiful? Here we are. Amen. People of God. Amen. We know, amen, we know his voice. And a stranger, we're not going to follow. Amen. Why? Because we know that we'll get off course and we'll get in trouble following the voice of a stranger. Glory to God. Moving in the volume of his understanding. Moving in the volume of his understanding. And again, Acts 17 and 28 says, in him we live. See, we as people of God, we live in him. We've laid aside every weight, every sin that so easily beset us, and now we are running this race with patience, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Hallelujah. Amen. For in him we live, and in him we move,
yes,
and in him we have our being. Oh, glory to God. In him, in Jesus, we have to know where our help lieth. Amen. The Holy Ghost that leads and guides us. Hallelujah. We have to lean and depend on the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Oh my God. Today, amen, we are excited, amen, about what the Lord is doing. Just a, amen, few more verses of scripture in the book of Romans, the 7th chapter and the 5th verse. Paul has said to the church at Rome, and Paul says, for when we were in the flesh, the motions of sin, which were by the law, did work in our members to bring forth fruit unto death. So Paul is talking here about the flesh man moving in sin, glory to God, and bringing forth the fruits of death. Oh, but amen, we don't have time to move in the flesh, glory to God. But we want to crucify that flesh. As Paul said, them old things, we want to cast them out. We want to walk away from them. Amen. We don't want them to be no more part, amen, of our life. Glory to God. Moving in the volume of his understanding. Hallelujah. Amen. And I know, amen, that you have taken a lot of notes today and a lot of scriptures today. But, amen, don't just take them and put them to the side and say, well, I heard another message. And, well, you can decide, amen, on whether it was good or not, amen. But I must say, amen, it's pretty good to me. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. It's pretty good to me because, amen, it's getting to, amen, the marrow, amen, of the bone. Hallelujah. Yeah. It's getting down where, amen, that it'll take out everything. Amen. That will separate, amen, me from the love of Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. I like to preach about myself. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm not like one of them preachers that say, do as I say do and not as I do. Amen. No, I don't teach that. Glory to God. Amen. But I want to live the life and I want to be an example of the love of Jesus Christ. I want to be an example. Hallelujah. Amen. I want to move in this message that we are preaching about today. Moving in the volume of his understanding. Glory to God. Oh, if it wasn't for Jesus, I don't know where I would be. And I got news for you. I'm glad I don't know, because I will never be without him. Hallelujah. Amen. All right. The 6th verse is still in that 7th chapter of the book of Romans. Paul says, but now we are delivered from the law. We are delivered from the law. What was the law? Amen. We were dead to sin. Amen. We were dead when we were in the law. We were dead. Wherein we were held that we should serve in newness of spirit and not in the oldness of the letter. Hallelujah. Amen. In other words, we know, amen, that the letter killeth, but it's that the spirit makes it alive. Hallelujah. Amen. There are many people that reads the word, amen, and the word never come alive in them. Hallelujah. But amen, the Spirit, the Holy Ghost, is what makes the word alive in you, me, or anybody else. Hallelujah. You can study the word. You can read the word, which is good. I'm not saying that you shouldn't read the word. But amen, get filled with the Holy Ghost, that word can come alive. And you will have a better understanding of the word when it comes alive in you. And the only thing that makes it alive in you is the Holy Spirit of the Holy Ghost. Oh, yes, yes, yes. In the book of Romans, the 8th chapter, and the first verse, Paul says to the church at Rome, there is, therefore, now, no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus. There we go again. No condemnation to those which are in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. You know, there were many people in Bible that was around Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, but amen, when he came into them is when the difference took place. Hallelujah. Today, we want to make sure that in him that we live, in him we move, and in him we have our being. Hallelujah. In other words, everything that he wants us to do, we ought to be found doing it. Hallelujah. Amen. In him, we move. In him, we live. And in him, we have our being. Moving in the volume or the measure of his understanding. Oh, glory to God. Therefore, there's no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Hallelujah. I like that. That walks not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Hallelujah. Oh, it's evident that the Spirit, it makes us alive. Come on. When the Holy Ghost live on the inside of us, we're some beautiful people. Oh yes, we are. Come on, we are more than just church people when the Spirit lives on the inside of us. Amen. But we are people that are seeking after God, seeking after his righteousness. When the Spirit lives on the inside of us. Hallelujah. The second verse in the 8th chapter of the book of Romans. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus had made me free from the law of sin and death. That's what Paul said there. Don't you want to be free today? Don't you want to be free today? Or if you're already free, don't you want to go higher? Glory to God. Don't you want to go higher? There's always higher heights and deeper depths for the people of God. Oh, yes. I know that I'm telling the truth. Because in this pandemic, I'm grateful for the platforms that we have that we can enjoy other ministries. And we have seen the growth of the people of God even at this 13 months of the pandemic. Hallelujah. I must say for myself, I feel the growth. I see the growth. That it might help the body of Christ. That it might help the members of the Miracle House of Prayer. That it might help the members of the Miracle House of Prayer churches. That it might help the members of the Full Gospel Fellowship churches. Hallelujah. Amen. There are higher heights and there are deeper depths in Him. My last verse, again, Romans 8 and 2. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus had made me free from the law of sin and death. Hallelujah. I'm glad to be able to share this message with you today. Moving in the volume of His understanding. Moving in the volume of His understanding. Keep in mind that Jesus said, not Paul, not Philip, but Jesus said, these works that I do, ye shall do, and greater works ye shall do. Talking about His disciples. Why? Because I go unto my Father. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord ever shine on you for giving your attention to this last 55 minutes that the Lord has given me to share this platform with you. We are thankful. We are grateful. We don't take it for granted, but we say thank you. Now, precious Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, even as we spoke the word that you have spoke to our hearts on today, to the body of Christ, and to those that do not know you, they can become to know you. We ask you to move in our society like never before. Thank you for the saved Christians everywhere. Thank you for the saved saints everywhere. But Lord, take us higher in you. Take us a deeper depth in you. Take us a higher height in you. And Lord Jesus, those that don't know you in the pardon of their sin, that don't know you as our Savior, Lord, touch them today. Save, heal their spirit, heal the brokenhearted in the mighty name of Jesus. And even as I stand before you today, as you listen to me today, if you don't know Jesus as your Savior, I want you to say these words and repeat after me and mean these words in your heart, and ye shall be saved. Say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. I heard the word today in a measure that I had not heard before, and I understand better now that if I want to see you in peace, I must repent of my sins now. Forgive me for all of my sins. Forgive me for the sins of omission. Forgive me for the sins of commission. I lay down my ways and I pick up the cross and I shall follow you the rest of my life in Jesus' name. Now, if you said that prayer and you believe in your heart what you said, not to Bishop, not to Pastor Lois, not unto whatever society you might be in, but unto Christ, you repented to Jesus and you believe now that you turned from your wicked ways and that you are not going back to the things of used to be. Hallelujah. Move away from used to be. Find joy in Jesus Christ. Find peace in Jesus Christ. Find love in Jesus Christ. And you, whoever you may be, You can become a disciple of Jesus Christ, and you can move in the volume of his understanding. In the mighty name of Jesus. Well, may the Lord bless you. Thank you for listening to us today. By the way, amen, of the Facebook. Thank you for listening to us by way of the teleconference line. And we are looking forward to next Sunday at 11 a.m. Central Time. We shall return to you again. The ministry of the Miracle House of Prayer, 604 East 38th Street, Houston, Texas, 77022. Amen. We'll be coming to you again. And remember, amen, we look forward to receiving letters from you. And amen. And we also look forward to receiving the telephone calls, amen, on the Miracle House of Prayer. Call line, amen, 800-870-3413. Amen, is our call line number for the Miracle House of Prayer. And our P.O. Box is P.O. Box 681-973, Houston, Texas, 77268. Amen. God bless you. We love you. Until next Sunday at 11 a.m. Central Time, this is Bishop and Pastor Coleman saying to you, we are marching to greater. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Marching to greater.